there were two explorers that were in eastern Congo that noticed a shrew that was the size of a small rat and was very furry. And in all other ways, it looked like a shrew. It had a pointed nose and black
that
color.
That seems kind of big for a shrew.
It was small rat size, which is huge for a shrew. This was a big shrew. And so these guys said, that's a pretty interesting shrew. And the local residents said, watch this. And they took a living shrew and they put it on the ground, and a full-grown man stood on it for 5 minutes and then stepped off, and this animal walked away. And if it had been any other, a rodent that size or another shrew that size, it would have been squashed flat.
Yeah.
So these folks collected a series of specimens and decided, well, let's dissect one and see what the vertebral column looks like.
It looks like a Trisket.
Let me show you what the next largest shrew would look like. Just like you and I, there are five lumbar vertebrae, and there are processes, just one or two that stick out on either side, and then a dorsal process. This is a hero shrew, and there are 10 to 11 lumbar vertebrae, and each vertebrae has 10 to 20 processes sticking out the side, and they're interlocked. So you and I have a lumbar vertebrae that are quite a bit bigger than the lumbar vertebrae of this shrew, but for the most part look the same. A camel, a bat, all of these animals have lumbar vertebrae that look relatively the same. Mm-hmm. The scutosaurus is the most bizarre mammalian backbone within the entire group of mammals because of this morphology. And it actually stretches even into the thoracic region there. You can see that that's expanded as well.
Why?
We didn't know. And in fact, we may still not know, but that's part of the story. For over 100 years since its discovery, the hero shrew has been known by only one species. And all the other shrews have a backbone that looks like this.
Yeah.
Many people think of evolution, you could take this form here and the form at the beginning, and the two would look completely different from one another, but you have these transformational forms in between that show the gradual change.
The missing links.
Exactly.
Okay.
There were no links in this from this to that. Some people suggested, well, perhaps this change went directly from this form to that form. 2 years ago in the Congo, we found another species of hero shrew, which is here. And you can see that, first of all, there are less lumbar vertebrae. There are 8 in this form. There are 10 to 11 here.
Mm-hmm.
And you can also see that the processes on this one are less, and they're bigger than here. So we have a form that may, and I say may because this may not be the case, but this very well could represent an intermediate form between this guy and that guy.
The missing link.
The missing link. Now, the aspect of this story that I think is the most intriguing is, what benefit does this backbone provide this animal?
Mm-hmm.
I remembered a conversation I had at the American Society of Mammalogists meetings in Missouri about 15 years ago with Lynn Robbins. He said, when I was in the Congo, I was asking local residents about where I could find hero shrews, and they said, oh, come with us when we go to the palm trees to harvest beetle grubs, because we always see them running around the base of the palm trees. And Lynn thought to himself, these people are pulling the bracts of the palm trees away from the trunk to access these huge beetle grubs. Maybe Scutosaurus is inserting itself in between the trunk and the leaf base and bending its back and able to pry the leaf base away and then access these concentrated sources of food that would be inaccessible to any other predator.
So it has a built-in crowbar.
So when I realized we had a new species of hero shrew, I called him up. I hadn't talked to him since the meetings.
Yeah.
I said, Lynn, you got to join us on this, and this is the perfect place to publish this hypothesis.
Mm-hmm.
Because neither of us have seen Scutosaurus do this. So that's all this is it's a hypothesis.
Mm-hmm.
But that's how science works. You get the idea out there, and other scientists subsequently will make observations and see if, in fact, that happens or not.
How many of these do we have here?
We probably have 20.
20? Mm. Oh, that seems like a lot. How many of these exist? One. This one.
This one. This is the holotype.
This is the only one in any museum in the world.
In the world.
And you're holding it right there.
Right there in my left hand.
This is so exciting.
Oh, yeah. It's.
I feel kind of honored to be talking to you right now, knowing
you can
that.
Hold it.
Oh, my gosh. This is it. This is the only one. This is so exciting. This is science. It still has brains on it.